Hello guys, today we continue Apollo Justice Ace Attorney. So in the last video, we in the part where judge says we don't have a decisive evidence. Now we'll press this load 3. This witness won't be coming back to the stand once we let him go. Every man has an igniter. Huh? Didn't you say the better the guitar, the brighter it burns, Prosecutor Gavin? Ah, yes. Good guitars are kept dry, is why. That provides the best sound. Even a small spark could cause irreparable damage. Your plan has an igniter in it too, detective. It was there from the very beginning. What? Fighting time, Justice! If you blow this one, it'll be out of your hand for good. Go for it, Apollo! What? And this igniter supposed to come burn me up? That's almost poetic there, Mr. Attorney. All the better, I'm rather fond of poetry. And I intend to hear this one through to the very end. Here, forehead. You are accusing this man, Darren, Kasken, of two crimes. The murder of Mr. Litos and the smuggling of a virgin and coupon. This is your last chance to prove your case. Israel has already run on for far too long. Mr. Justice, this will be my last warning. This will be my last warning. The moment this igniter of yours turns out to be a dud, is the moment this cross-examination ended. Understood? Yes, but what should I present? The guitar? Question mark? Yes, Your Honor. Then let's have it. Show us the basis for this accusation against Darren Kasken. Okay, this is really my last chance. The key that will take a part of Darren Kasken. Ah! Should I call the witness or present evidence? I don't know. I feel like the evidence I already present it all except this, the postcard. Oh, this already present it too. Call it witness. Your igniter isn't a piece of evidence. Huh? So what it is? It is true that I can't show decisive evidence. But perhaps what I needed to prove my case was something else. You mean a witness. Proving his guilt is a tall order. But I got just the person to do it. Very well, Mr. Justice. Who is this person who can prove Darren Kasken guilt? Oh my god, who should I call? I just push all the buttons I know to choose. Oh my god. I feel like calling Machi is the most normal, is the most good option in this case. You know what, I just call it. The person who can prove, okay, is the defendant, Machi Tobaye. Your client again? Machi Tobaye was an accomplice to the cocoon smuggling plot. Without him, Darren Kasken could not have gotten the cocoon. Furthermore, he can easily prove that one the one who plotted to smuggle that cocoon, is the real criminal in this case. How so? It would require just one of the very cocoon Mr. Itos was looking for. With the cooperation of the Republic of Virginia, we could burn a cocoon. The burned cocoon would leave a particular residue. A residue we would no doubt also find inside the burnout guitar. Huh, very scientific of you. Save. 6. Thus, if Machito Baye acknowledged his agreement with Darren Kresken concerning the attempt of smuggling of a Virginian cocoon, the case is solved. I don't like his laugh. I hate you so much. No. This game is giving me mixed signal. Save again. But you're wrong, Detective Kresken. What? It's the other way around. If Machi doesn't admit to smuggling here, he's in deep trouble. Huh? How? Look, if Machi admits to some smuggling here, then he betrayed in our courts by our laws. You don't get the death penalty for smuggling in our country. The victim in this case was an undercover Interpol agent. I'm sure that news has already reached Virginia, and they likely broadcast our dealings in court today, including the part about Virginian cocoon. Yeah, but if Machi doesn't admit to smuggling now, save 6. He eventually be picked up by Virginian police, and it's not like he's in any danger in our court. We're not going to find him guilty of murder here, not now. Yeah, but you can't do this. Why? You can't accuse me. Maybe the law doesn't allow it, but who's going to think you're really innocent after hearing this trial? The same goes for Machito Baye. The cocoon smuggling your entire plan. Machito Baye knows everything. There's only one way out of it for him, and that's to acknowledge his own crime. The crime of cocoon smuggling. Don't worry there. I get you out of the country. I set you up someplace a hidden mansion real nice. You want a house made of a cookie or no? A house made of pianos? Come on. What? Save 3. Darren, I consider that my last session with you. We rock. I'm guessing we can treat that outburst as a confession. He's laughing again. There's a kind of sick desperation in it now, though. Well, have you been listening to today's trial? Yes. And you talk? You tell Discord everything? I didn't want it to turn out this way, but I'm not the kind of lawyer that can overlook a crime. Today's trial was all for the benefits, you know. I see no reason why you should hesitate now. I knew from very beginning, I knew. Machi. Situation I cannot explain, but money I needed. Very much money. Today's trial, This is a delicate issue with our legal system. The only thing definite in court of law is evidence. Safe 3. This is the golden rule. However, it has become apparent that not all things can be tried by this standard. Should another case of this sort surface, we may have to consider an alternate system by which to administer justice. Anyway, Mr. Justice Tobaye, yes, I promise you will receive a fair trial by the law of our country. And with regards to the current charges for the murder of Mr. Litos, this court is prepared to announce the verdict. Okay, that's a good therapy shock. I thank you. I only lie, but you see true, you find true. That's our job. Very well. This court finds the defendant Machi Tobaye. Yay! Yay! Congratulations, Machi Tobaye. Court is adjourned. Yay! Safe 3. July 10, 4:42 p.m. District Court, Defendant Lobby Number 2. I wonder what happened to Machi. Well, he did smuggle a cocoon out of Virginia. I guess there'll be another trial here. Oh well, that sent well. Daddy! I owe you both my thanks. Lamiroir? My, is something wrong? I'm sorry, I... Machi was your partner on stage, your friend? Yes, I thought of him as my own son. Even now I do, yet... Something got a hold of him, something evil, I see that. And he must pay for what he has done. Is that not how it should be? I'm still sorry. Do not be sorry. You have given me courage. Courage? I am considering an eye operation. It was my suggestion, actually. You mean you'll be able to see me again? To see again? It's funny. I have always been afraid of the light. Light seems so harsh too, so unforgiving. According to the doctor, Lamiroy lost her sight due to some kind of accident. An accident? As you know, I suffer from amnesia. I feared that if I could see... Safe 3. Perhaps it would open my eyes to the truth I have been running from. I was scared. You know what changed her mind? Hearing your defense in there today. She could feel your gaze, unwavering, always looking straight at the truth. If the light returns to my eyes, I think I will take up painting. Painting? That's right! She's the landscape painter in Sun after all. I will paint the two of you, I promise. Woohoo! I can't wait, Lamiroir! I owe you my thanks to Apollo. Thanks, Mr. Red, but for what? You reminded me I need to hurry things along. On my secret mission, that is. Right, your secret mission. Apollo, trustee. I hope that we will meet again someday soon. You bet! Me too! Yay! And so, like a ballad, the trial flowed on and on until it came to the end. Thanks to the trial, the guitar serenade was a huge hit. Prosecutor Gavin's even more dazzling to look at now. But there's something I want to say to that guy. Next time you write a ballad, have them catch the killer at the end. Yay! Oh, this is the last episode, I think. Okay. Let me save first. Okay. Turn board succession. Yes. Confirm. Save 3. Okay, that's it for today, guys. Bye bye.